is not lost for Jack's Boathouse. It's been a staple along the Georgetown waterfront for generations now. But the owner of the Washington landmark is being asked to leave. Derek Ward, rather, has more on what's being called a Dear John letter from the Park Service.
There have been lots of changes along the Georgetown waterfront in recent years, but for the past 70 years, there's been a Jack's Boathouse. John Jack Baxter leased the land from the old Washington flour mill and began building boats and renting canoes in the shadow of Key Bridge. A few years ago, the land became officially part of Rock Creek Park under the control of the National Park Service.
We've been working with the Park Service, kind of a handshake relationship where we pay a concession rent for years, for decades.
Current owner Paul Simpkin says that relationship has been good.
We're even told by the Park Service we did a great job.
They were expecting a long-term lease, but what they got last week was a kind of Dear John letter from the Park Service.
We found just a form letter saying that we were terminated and had to be out in 30 days. Everything had to be out in 30 days.
They're in winter mode now, closed for the season. But in season, the place is immensely popular with its down-to-earth vibe and community of those who cherish the river. Simpkin says so far, no one for the Park Service has returned his calls. The National Park Service tells News 4 in a written statement that Simpkin's current lease is no longer considered valid. The statement also says that, quote, the recreational services offered and public access to the Potomac River are important to NPS and will be offered as a concession contract. So Simpkin will essentially have to submit a proposal to operate the business which he has run for years. It's unclear, however, why he got the eviction notice and if he'll still have to comply. Simpkin says if he has to clear the site down to the gravel, there's no way he could move back in. Fans of Jack's Boathouse have started a Facebook page to circulate a petition, and they're contacting city officials for more help. Meanwhile, there's an unenviable task at hand for Simpkin, notifying his 27 employees over the holidays and the uncertainty the new year will bring.
A lot of them, this is what they do. So right now, my position is trying to let those folks know what's going on.
On the Georgetown waterfront, Derek Ward, News 4.
Now, late today, News 4 talked with D.C. Delegate Eleanor Holmes Norton. She's a member of the House committee that oversees the Park Service and says she'll be looking into the matter after the holidays.